प्री दर्शन एंड फ्लैग होइस्टिंग। लिसन चिल्ड्रन, इट वॉज इवनिंग टाइम। एज यूजुअल आयुष, अमन, अतुल, आशीष एंड आहान वर इन द पार्क। एवरी डे दे वुड मीट इन द पार्क अराउंड 5 PM। वाई? टू प्ले क्रिकेट। But that day, all of them were sitting quietly. None of them were playing. They were not in a mood to play. Why? They were all very disturbed by an incident that happened in their class that day. It was all due to their classmate, Darshan. Actually, you know what happened that day when Ayush opened his desk in his class? A rat jumped out of his desk. Ayush was scared and stunned. He tried to run away, and doing so, what happened? He fell down and hurt himself. Other children in the class began shouting, running here and there. Ayush began crying and he sat down on the ground. He was in pain. Ashish helped him to get up while Ahan brought some water. Atul looked at his feet and said, Ayush, you are hurt. Come, I will take you to the sick room where nurse auntie will put a bandage round your wound. After some time, all was quiet in the class. When Ayush returned from the sick room, Darshan got up and began laughing. He went to Ayush and said, Ha ha, Ayush, you are such a coward. You just got scared by this plastic mouse? Yes, Darshan had a plastic mouse in his hand and he started laughing. Ha 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 ha. A coward, Ayush. He started clapping his hands. Now everyone in the class knew that who it was, Darshan's mischief. Darshan had joined school last year. He was very naughty. He would play pranks on his classmates and trouble them, harass them. He would often get a scolding from his class teacher, Mrs. Goel, but Darshan would never pay heed to her. That day when Mrs. Goel came, Ayush complained about Darshan and Mrs. Goel got angry. She said, Darshan, what is this? Every day you are up to one or the other mischief. There's not a single day when I don't get your complaint. Mind you, this is my last warning, or else I will complain to the principal, ma'am. She might even get you out of the school. So now onwards, pay attention to your studies. No more mischief. And yes, first go and apologize to Ayush. And so, children, that is what happened that day in class. Now, all the friends were sitting quietly. Aman said, today what Darshan did was very, very bad. His mischiefs are increasing day by day. We have to do something to stop him. We have to teach him a lesson. All the others joined him. Yes, Aman, you are right. We have to teach him a lesson. Now, as it was getting dark, all of them bid goodbye to each other and went home. The next day, when Mrs. Goel came to the class, she said, children, tomorrow is 15th August, our Independence Day. All of you have to come to school for the flag hoisting. Every year, we have some guests for flag hoisting, but this year, it is decided that it will be done by one of our brilliant students of our school. And you know who is chosen this year? Yes, Ayush of our class. Just then, Darshan got up from his seat. Ma'am, not Ayush. This year, I want to hoist the flag. Mrs. Goel said, no, Darshan, not you. You are always playing mischief in the class. Ayush is good both in studies and sports. He is a well-mannered child. Darshan did not like this. He was already angry with Ayush for the scolding he got yesterday. Now on 14th August, what was done? A pole was set up on the ground and children, some rose petals were put inside the flag. You know why? so that when the flag would be unfolded, petals would scatter all around. Darshan was seeing all this. He was going on murmuring, "Oh, how nice it would have been if I could hoist the flag." Why Ayush? He felt jealous of Ayush. And then an idea came to his mind. How to trouble Ayush. Do you know, children, what did Darshan do? When nobody was around, he stealthily crept towards the flag, opened it and removed the petals and put some mud inside it and again packed the flag. Wow! Tomorrow when Ayush will pull the string of the flag, all the mud will fall on him and everyone will laugh. Ha ha ha! How clever I am, Darshan said. Next day, the principal, all the teachers and students had gathered on the ground for the flag hoisting. Principal ma'am said, "Hello children, a very happy Independence Day to all of you. Children, we celebrate this day to rejoice our freedom from British rule and pay homage to our freedom fighters. Children, these leaders and freedom fighters had to struggle a lot, to fight a lot, and they have set a stepping stone for glorified India. And as citizens of India, it is our responsibility, our duty to complete their vision of a glorified India. And yes, we also have a flag hoisting. And children, as you all know, this year we gave the honor to our capable student Ayush of class 8. Come, Ayush, come forward." Ayush came forward. He held the mic in his hand and said, "A very happy Independence Day to everybody. Thank you, ma'am, for this honor. But I have a request to make." "What request, Ayush?" ma'am asked. Ayush said, "Excuse me, ma'am, but I wish that today's flag hoisting be done by Darshan. Darshan really wanted to do it and after all, he is my classmate. Let him hoist the flag." Everyone there shouted, "No, no, not Darshan." But when Ayush insisted again and again, ma'am said, "Come, Darshan, come. Come forward." And a teacher handed over the string to Darshan. Darshan was very upset and puzzled. He wanted to refuse, but yet he couldn't. He began thinking, "Oh, I cannot refuse. If I tell the truth, then I will be caught and punished. If I hoist the flag, then all the mud will fall on me and everyone will laugh at me. Oh, what to do?" Just then the principal ma'am said, "Darshan, what are you waiting for? Come. Pull the string and hoist the flag." And what did Darshan do? He tightly closed his eyes and pulled the string. "Oh, now the mud will fall on me and everybody will laugh at me." But to his surprise, something surely dropped. It was not mud, but rose petals. Darshan quickly opened his eyes. He looked around. He looked at Ayush. He was smiling at him, nodding his head. By the time the singing of the national anthem, Jana Gana Mana, was over, Darshan understood what actually happened and what was the truth. He felt ashamed of himself. He slowly moved towards the mic and began saying, "Hello everyone. I am sorry for all the pranks, all the mischiefs I played on others. Please forgive me. I am even ready to accept any punishment that can be given to me. Actually, I was angry with Ayush and when he got a chance to hoist the flag, I was jealous of him and I wanted to harass him. I put mud instead of rose petals in the flag. But Ayush, yes, he replaced the petals again. Now I have understood how much I hurt others when with my pranks. I was wrong. I promise never to do any such thing again. I will change my habits and become a well-mannered boy. Everybody, please forgive me. Please forgive me. Hearing this, Mrs. Goel, the class teacher of Darshan, was very happy. She came forward. She patted Darshan and said, "Wow, that's very nice from you. From now onwards, Darshan, you have to spread happiness. Be friends with everybody like rose petals and not dirt like mud. You have learned a good lesson today. God bless you." And children, Atul, Ashish, Aman, Ayush and Ahan all went towards Darshan and hugged him. "From now onward, Darshan, you are also a good friend." So children, you must have also learned how to behave and treat others. And children, how did you like this story? Do message me.